Well, praise the Lord. It's another Thursday evening, and a beautiful evening at that. Temperature is warm. The skies are blue, at least here in Pennsylvania, where we're broadcasting tonight. I lost my thought there because I was thinking about those in these different countries that are listening as well by radio, and I'm sitting here talking about beautiful skies and warm air, and they might be hanging up because it's foggy, rain, cold, whatever it might be. So for that, I apologize. I'll quit talking about how we're being blessed over here. But anyways, with that being said, tonight's guest speaker is he's not only my pastor, he's my brother, and he's my friend. And I would just, I enjoy so much being in church and listening to the messages that the Lord has given them, so much that I want to share that with all of you. So with that being said, Pastor Paul, the floor is all yours.
Thank you.
Amen, amen. You know, as I listen to this message, you know, you're talking about total submission. You know, totally submitting to God in all aspects of your life. And that's hard for a lot of us to do. A lot of us are controlling type people, you know, trying to hang on to things because we feel vulnerable by letting them go. And, you know, and what you're talking about and what I'm hearing is, you know, being totally transparent. And even though we know that God knows everything, we still have things in our lives that we try to hide. And as I listen to you, you're talking about totally releasing all of that and totally giving it, you know, totally giving it all up. And, you know, you know, brother, I'm in 100% agreement with you. Again, for a lot of people, that's hard. That's hard for me. You know, I'm a take control type person. I can do this. I can do this. I'll work it out. I'll figure something out. You know, but you're right. You know, when you get to that point where you just surrender it all to God, then that it's like a burden is lifted off of you. And it's like, well, Lord, this is on you. That's nothing to do with me now. So if it goes good or it goes bad, it wasn't because of me. You know, I've totally surrendered it. And that's hard to do. Amen, amen. You know that what pops in my mind when I'm thinking about that, I remember years ago I did something stupid and I was in a position where I literally had to lay a motorcycle down. I was going across the wide parking lot, headed out into a pretty busy intersection, and I knew I had to put it down. And right when that bike would get to the point of leaning where I knew the next flinch I was going to lose control, I would snag it back up again. And I just kept getting closer and closer to that destructive point until finally I just had to slam it down onto the pavement. And that's where that's what comes to my mind as I'm listening to this, you know, because we all know, we've all been in that, whether a bicycle or whatever, you know, where you go to give it up totally, but at the last minute that flesh in you jerks it back, takes it back, want to keep control of that and not let it go, until finally you got to slam it down or you're done. You're going to run into destruction. Amen, amen. If anybody else has any comments, feel free. You know, when I'm talking, you just got to jump in. But yeah, you know, we know God's sovereign, and we know that His plan is the best plan. And we read all the scriptures. You know, take on His burden. His yoke is light, You know, take it to the altar. Leave it at the foot of the cross. Don't take it back with you. You know, that he'll take control of it all and just, you know, and I want to show you another example of how that happened. You know, even with this radio broadcast and this ministry, I always worried, you know, oh man, I gotta fill these blocks up. I need names in these blocks, and I wonder who's going to come and listen, and I want this and I want that. And then the Lord laid it on my heart that it has nothing to do with me. I'm just a guy that opens the door. And I'll tell you what, there was a burden that was lifted off of me, because that's his job. That's on the Lord. You know, it's the Lord's round table. It's his ministry. It has nothing to do with me. I just open the door. Yeah, come on in. The lights are on. Come on in and get a chair. Sit down. You know, and then I close the door. That's all I do, because I let go of all that other stuff, and I just gave it to the Lord. And now it's a joy. You know, there's no burdensome to it. And I think that's the way it is in our lives. You know, we burden over crazy things, where if we just surrender them and give them to the Lord and forget about it. And you know, when you stop thinking about it, you look at a lot of these older, you know, 1800 evangelists and all these that we hear about, you know, they would give it to the Lord and they'd just walk away and forget about it. Wouldn't even give it another thought. You know, I dealt with it. I gave it to the Lord. Now it's his. I don't need to be concerned about that no more. And you've seen how God used them in a mighty way through their ministries. And it's just amazing. But there again, it all comes back to the same thing. You know, we're, for the most part, we're control freaks. We want to keep control of everything in our lives.
Amen. Amen.
All the time. All the time. Amen. 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 All the time. We see it each and every day. Well, brother, we definitely appreciated you being with us tonight and, you know, opening your heart up to us like that. And like you said, and Mona as well, there's somebody that needed to hear that. You said that when you first started the message, that there's somebody out here that has something going on in their lives that they need to let go of it and just let God have control of it and, you know, trust and know that He will take care of it. So it was an awesome message, brother. It's something we all needed to hear because there's points in all of our lives where we don't truly let go. You know, we continue to hang on. And I even think about those with drug addictions. You know, I have, I knew a man, he's passed now, and he asked God why he wouldn't take the pornography away from me. He says, because there's a part of you that won't let it go. There's a part of you that's hanging on to it. And, you know, I believe that to be true in these addictions as well. As every aspect of our life. But with that being said, nobody leaves before we pray you out. Amen? So, Father God, we just thank you for our brother, Lord, that he come to share his heart with us. And, Lord, even as he was struggling with the message that he was going to bring and what he thought he was going to bring wasn't what he brought. He let go of that, and he brought what you had for him. You knew who was going to be listening. You knew who would be on the line, who would be listening by radio. You know who's going to come back and listen to it later. If it was for somebody that's coming back for later, we don't know that. But Lord, you do, and that's why you had him bring the message that he did, and we thank you for that. We thank you that he's obedient to you, Lord. He could have brought the first message, and nobody would have received it because you knew what they needed to hear. So I praise you for that, Lord. You are a sovereign God, a loving God, an almighty God. And we give you all praise, glory, and honor. So, Father God, we lift our brother up to you, Lord, praying your protection, your blessings upon him, your protection around his family, Lord God. And, Father God, that everything that he puts his hands to, Lord, that you bless. Father, even in as pastors have so many decisions that they have to make on a regular basis and they seek you for these answers, Lord, you know the decisions that my brother has to make and the different things that he has brought to you. And I know, Lord, that you'll send him in the right direction. And I know he'll hear your voice when you speak to him. Your word says that the sheep know the shepherd's voice, and he's truly one of your sheep. So, Father, I pray for all those that have been listening here tonight, Lord, that they'll think about this message and take it and realize that there is things in all of our lives. Might seem small, but it's not small to God. You just got to let it go. I pray for all those that are listening, for family members that are possibly lost and without Jesus. I pray, Father, that they feel that drawing of your Holy Spirit upon them. And, Father, for all those that are listening, Lord, I pray, Father, that they feel that drawing as well. So, Father God, as we come before you, we come in the blessed and the holy name of our Lord and Savior Jesus. Amen, amen. And I'd like to say to all those that are listening, you heard the message tonight. and you think that there's things in your life that's hard to let go, but there's one thing more important that you got to think about, and that's letting go of yourself. Not the struggles in your life, not the addictions in your lives. Those are, right now, those are just non-essentials. They're the minors. You got to worry about the major, and that's letting go of yourself. That's surrendering yourself totally unto Jesus Christ. Then you have a God that steps in and takes control of your life. And you think, well, I'm really not sure. And, you know, I got so much stuff in my life. I just don't know which way to turn. And all the you don't know the evil and wicked things that I've done. Well, let me tell you something. There's nothing new under the sun. All things, there's nothing that's uncommon to man. What you're struggling with, we've struggled with. And there are probably even things in our lives that you wouldn't even have considered doing. But God forgave us and He'll forgive you. It's just a matter of, again, letting go and letting God come into a place in your life where you know you have a need for the risen Savior. And if you don't know without any doubt that if something happened to you right now, because we know that today's not promised to, tomorrow's not promised to us. But if you don't know without any doubt that if something happened to you right now, that when you stood before God, what would He say if you didn't know? That He would say, come in, my good and faithful servant, or depart from me. If you don't know, I can pretty much tell you. If something happened to you, you'd break hell wide open. You'd say, well, that's kind of harsh. Well, that's the truth. And better that you hear it from me than you hear it from God. So I would highly recommend that you get yourself to a little quiet place, pull over the side of the road, pull in a parking lot, or for those of you that are not driving, walk out of the room if there's somebody around and just say, Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. And I know that from what I've heard, that if I died right now, I would be casted into outer darkness. I'd be separated from you. And I don't want that. I want you to forgive me of my sins and come into my life and be my Lord and my Savior. That's all it takes. It don't take fancy words. It don't take fancy clothes, going to a fancy building. It just takes a humbled heart to let go and let God. So with that being said, I pray that all of you, that you will really search your hearts, because this is the most important decision that you could ever make. And you don't want to let this day go by. You don't want to let this moment go by, because again, the next moment's not yours. So I'd like to say goodnight to each and every one that have been here. It's been a pleasure having you here. And we look forward to tomorrow night as well. And for those of you who are thinking about cults and all cults, and you know, some of you might want to know how to witness to the different religious cults that there are, come and join with us. We have some people that's coming on and going to be teaching us a few things. And you don't have to be a truck driver to come to the Christian Truckers Network. So with that being said, I bid each and every one of you a good evening. And I pray that you all have a better day tomorrow. And with that being said, God bless and good night. There you go. Good word, brother.